Wendell Ford was born on September 8, 1924, in a town near Owensboro. He is the son of Ernest and Irene Ford.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again.
Mr. President, as the 105th Congress comes to a close, I want to take a moment to say thank you to my fellow colleagues who, like me, will be retiring this year. I came to the Senate in 1974 with Senators Glenn and Bumpers. It was a different time. Campaigns were still won by going door to door, when the Senate itself was much more open to compromise and bipartisanship.
Wendell Ford's exhibit was founded by himself and is dedicated to engaging citizens of all ages in the governmental process. Visitors can learn about Senator Ford's long career in local, state, and national government while learning about the dynamic participatory form of governance.
From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston.
It goes to the heart of our system of democracy, and whether it works or will continue to work, there has got to be a better way. There are also a lot of ideas around here on how to make it a better way. I can only hope that some of these ideas are translated into law in the very near future. Well, Mr. President, I wish my colleagues well. I will miss this institution dearly. I will miss the daily interaction with my colleagues, many of whom have become such dear friends to me. Let me thank you for your friendship. And lastly, let me thank the staff. My personal office staff, both here and in the state, have been like family to me. I've tried to treat them that way, and it has been mutual. The committee staff, the floor staff, I have the privilege to work with over the years, have all been great to me as well. They make this place run and make us all look good from time to time. I want to thank them all for their support.
God bless the
The Wendell H. Ford Regional Training Center is located in the heart of Western Kentucky, just outside of Greenville. Soldiers are able to go to the training center and receive the chance to compete for wanted slots for attendance to notable Army schools such as Airborne and Air Assault. These courses offer specialized training that few soldiers receive during their careers.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife.
The Western Kentucky Parkway was named after Wendell Ford in 1998. It is a controlled access highway running from Elizabethtown, Kentucky to near Eddyville, Kentucky, and one of nine highways that are part of the Kentucky Parkway system.
And I'm proud to be an American. The men who died, who gave that right to me, and I